A sosit momentul cadoului nostru special pentru toți iubitorii de muzică bună, pentru romantici și nu numai. Să știți că suntem singura echipă din România care a fost la Enrique Iglesias acasă la Miami și suntem tare mândri de asta.
Mărturisirile despre viața de star internațional și secretele care se află în spatele unuia dintre cei mai de succes artiști ai momentului, Enrique Iglesias, le veți auzi chiar acum, numai aici, în exclusivitate pentru Vorbește Lumea.
Ne aflăm în fața studioului The Hit Factory din Miami. Aici au venit de-a lungul vremii vedete internaționale de top, precum Michael Jackson, Adele sau membrii trupelor ABBA și Bee Gees, pentru a înregistra piese care i-au făcut mai apoi celebri în toată lumea. Astăzi, un alt nume important din industria muzicală se află aici. Este vorba despre Enrique Iglesias, care ne-a invitat în acest loc special pentru a ne acorda un interviu în exclusivitate despre viața lui în Miami, dar și despre vizita pe care se pregătește să o facă în curând în România. Haideți să intrăm! Thank you for taking your time for this interview.
Thank you.
What memories do you have from Romania, from last time you were there?
It was an interesting show because I remember watching Michael Jackson live from Romania in the same stadium, and to be able to stand there and put on a show in that same stadium in Romania was very special. What I want people to experience in one of my shows is just for those 2 hours to just forget about all the, you know, all the bad things, all the bad times, and just have a good time. Just hopefully I can entertain and I can give them 2 hours of fun.
Apparently the women have a lot of fun at your concerts. How do you feel?
And the men.
And the men, but mostly the women. But how do you feel when you see them screaming and singing with you and doing all those crazy things?
I don't know. That's true. We did a study, and the same amount of men had fun in our concerts. Actually, if you're a smart man, you come to one of my concerts because you're going to meet a lot of women. No, I'm kidding.
Yeah, good point.
Yeah.
Will you do in Romania the same that you do in other concerts, to choose a woman from the public to come on stage with you?
How do you not do that in every concert?
Because I watched on YouTube.
Yes, but in YouTube they don't show you the whole thing.
Mostly.
No, not really. Sometimes it's a girl, sometimes it's a guy. Whoever just catches your attention. I like having fun on stage. I like bringing people on stage where it's not rehearsed, where it's you get to meet someone, you never know how they're going to react, and it's a lot of fun.
You got a man?
What?
You got a man, boyfriend?
No.
I'm going to be your man for the next 5 minutes.
What do they have to do to catch your attention and to be the one that you asked for to come to the stage?
I've been asked a lot of times, what is it that you have to do? Nothing in particular. It's just, I don't know if it's someone, the way how they're screaming or how they're trying to get your attention. I truly don't know. You just gravitate towards someone and you pick that one person.
Enrique Iglesias a avut din totdeauna muzica în sânge. A moștenit această pasiune de la tatăl lui. Julio Iglesias este artistul latin care a vândut cele mai multe albume din istorie și a început cariera la o vârstă fragedă și este considerat o legendă vie a muzicii latino. Cu toate acestea, în momentul în care s-a hotărât să se apuce și el de cântat, Enrique nu s-a îndreptat către tatăl lui pentru a-i cere sfaturi. A vrut să vadă dacă poate avea succes fără ca lumea să-l știe drept băiatul lui Julio. În 1995 a înregistrat în secret primul său album sub numele de Enrique Martinez.
I remember not wanting to tell my parents. Part of it was because I was a little superstitious, and I always felt since I was a very young kid that if you spoke about things before they happened, they would never actually happen. So I was a firm believer in that. And I also felt that if I was going to make any mistakes, I'd rather make my own mistakes instead of other people make those mistakes for me.
Se pare că alegerea lui Enrique a fost una inspirată. Muzica lui a fost apreciată și la scurt timp a semnat un contract cu o importantă casă de discuri. Abia atunci artistul și-a dezvăluit adevărata identitate și a mărturisit că cea care l-a împrumutat cu bani pentru a-și înregistra primul album a fost chiar bona lui. Spanioloaica Elvira Olivares l-a crescut de mic. Părinții lui au divorțat când el era doar un copil. La vârsta de 9 ani, Enrique împreună cu fratele și sora lui s-au mutat în Miami cu tatăl lor. Julio Iglesias era însă mai tot timpul în studioul de înregistrări sau plecat în turnee, așa că artistul a fost crescut de dădaca lui.
How is your relationship with her now?
It's great. She's like a, she is like a mom to me, and she's here part of the year with me in Miami. I always tell her that, you know, she took care of me for the first 18 years of my life. Now I take care of her. She's a sweetie. She's still just as strict, by the way. If I come back home late, she gets mad.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So she lives with you in the house?
She lives with me part of the year, and then the other part of the year she lives in Spain. So she goes back and forth. But when she's here, she's strict.
Even if you're turning 40 in May?
Even, it doesn't matter, you know. If I go out one night and I get a little tipsy and I come back home, she always tells me, why do you do that?
Enrique Iglesias se emoționează de fiecare dată când vorbește despre bona lui, Elvira Olivares. Ei i-a dedicat primul său album și, de altfel, tot succesul de care s-a bucurat după. Dintr-un copil timid care și-a înregistrat primele piese în secret, Enrique a ajuns să concureze cu tatăl său. În 1998, cei doi au fost nominalizați la titlul de cel mai bun artist latino, în cadrul celui mai important eveniment muzical al anului.
For the first time ever, a father and son, Julio and Enrique are competing for the same award.
When we are nominated, or we have been nominated in the past in the same category, I'd rather him win than I win.
Really?
Yeah.
Why?
I don't know. He's my father. Let him, you know. I'm happier if he wins.
And the winner is Julio Iglesias.
You know, when they tell you that your son is against you in competition, you feel a little like with your brains in another place, because I adore my kids. Anyway, the first thing I have to say, more than anything, to tell my son that as much I will be on a stage, as much I will compete with them.
I love him, I respect him. I've always been a huge fan, and he's been able to become a legend in his own right, and at the same time still be a good father, which is very complicated and very difficult, and he's managed both of them very well.
You've been in the music industry for many years now, but do you remember how it was like when you had your first hit on radios?
Yes, very well. I was just a kid. I was in my teens. I remember the first time hearing one of my songs on the radio driving here in Miami to the studio. It was unbelievable. It felt, in a way, I felt so happy, but I also felt so embarrassed, because it was a song that I had written when I was 15, 16. And I was like, oh my goodness, I cannot believe people are actually listening to this right now.
This is Enrique, who likes girls like crazy.
Did music help you best this shyness?
Yes, 100%. Music to me was like therapy. It definitely did. Because I was always afraid of rejection when I was in my teens. And in high school, I was always afraid of going up to the girl that you liked and being rejected. So I think as time went on, that kind of changed. Not that I'm the complete opposite now, but I'm not as shy.
You're more confident.
Definitely not as shy. Man, where were these women when I was in high school, when I was in school? It feels great to be on stage. I can't believe that somebody actually wants my autograph, that somebody actually wants to take a picture with me. If it wasn't for them, I would have no career, I would have no life. And music to me has always been what's made me the happiest.
Except for the music, what's the second thing that makes you the happiest?
Being home with my girlfriend, my dog, just having a good time. Just a day off where you're just hanging out. It's not raining, it's sunny. Where you go out on the boat and just relax, just watch my dog swim, go swimming. That's when I'm the second happiest.
Okay, now let's go to the questions that all the ladies want to know. Are you a romantic man like your songs are?
I wouldn't say I'm a romantic man the way my songs are. I think that's how I would like to be. That's why I write them. A lot of the times, the reasons why I write it is because I can't express it, or I can't tell that person face to face. So that's why I write it.
Your new album is called Sex and Love. Why this title?
Sex and Love, just because there's songs that talk about sex. It's pretty simple. And songs that talk about love and songs that talk about sex and love.
Why is sex the first?
Oh, why didn't I put love first?
Yeah.
Sex and love just sounded better.
This is the only reason?
Yes. Not because sex, I didn't do it because sex was more important. I just thought it sounded better than saying love and sex.
I think both are very important. So far, I can tell you that to me is a combination of both, and it's like balance, like everything in life. But it depends what time, where you are in your life. Obviously, if you're 18, I would say probably sex is more important than love. And as you get older, you start realizing that love is just as important, if not more important.
Enrique Iglesias a găsit dragostea adevărată în 2001, pe când filma videoclipul piesei Escape. Atunci a cunoscut-o pe jucătoarea de tenis Anna Kournikova, de care s-a îndrăgostit la prima vedere. Și acum, după 14 ani de relație, vorbește despre ea la superlativ.
She's loving, she's caring, she's loyal. Go through your good times, you go through your bad times, and you realize that those good times are totally worth it.
They said on the news that you got married, I don't know, hundreds of times. Is this real, or are you planning to do a wedding?
I've been through 5 marriages and 6 divorces. So,
when is the real wedding going to come?
The real wedding? No, I just told you. No, I'm kidding. No. A lot of times I've said that to me, marriage was not that important, and a lot of people think I'm against marriage. I'm not against marriage at all whatsoever. I actually think it's cool. It's great. To me, it's not really defined my relationship with my girlfriend, especially when you've been together for quite a while. I think that's more important than.
So you don't want to do this step right
that
now?
That doesn't mean I don't want to. I don't necessarily think it's going to make me happier, but my girlfriend wants to get married. I'm totally cool with that. And to me, it would be one of those things that would be fun to do after you've been with someone for quite a while.
Did you talk about getting married? Like a real talk?
Not really, no. Mm-hmm. No.
But about children?
About children? We talk about children, yeah. I mean, at home, I guess that's one of those things where you never know if you're going to be ready. A lot of times I feel like I'm not mature enough to have children, which I shouldn't say that at my age.
But do you see yourself being a father with a lot of children?
I don't know if with a lot of children. I see myself being a father, but no, I don't know if a lot of children. Maybe two, maybe one, I don't know.
Do you have a message for all your fans in Romania?
My message is that I will be there in May, and I promise, I give you my word that the show is going to be a lot of fun.
Okay, thank you for choosing Vorbește Lumea Show on Pro TV for this exclusive interview.
Thank you. I just want you to know that I watch your show every day on satellite TV. And Abel, my road manager, he actually watches it weekly.
It's good to know that you are watching us. I want to give you a present now. I know you are a big fan of caps. You are wearing them 99.9% of your interviews and concerts. So I have prepared one cap for you. My colleague Mihai will help me. If you need one to match your outfit in Bucharest.
Oh, thank you very much.
Maybe you can wear this one.
Thank you very much.
It's with Bucharest.
You can try it. Thank you very much. Oh, thank you.
Mwah. Mwah. Thank you. You can try it. Do you want to try it?
I don't want to try it right now because I'm not having a good hair day, but I will in Bucharest.
Okay, good. So we are waiting to see you at the concert wearing this cap. Baby, don't blame me. I'm just a freak.